Dire Team Ban.
What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Pro Dota English channel, where we're casting the National Cup. This is going to be game two between, well, now tagged up as Dota 2 Bulgaria, so that's nice of them to have that, and Team Denmark. I'm Mike Loris, going to be joined by Kefka. Currently, Bulgaria have a one-game lead, and if they win this one, they're going to be on top of the group. Not sure how long that's going to stay, if it's going to stay at all, but hey, it's good at least to have that for a little bit. We'll see if they can actually pull it together. This draft actually going pretty darn slowly. Nightstalker, Doom, you know, who knows, Winter Wyvern, Undying, Alchemist. Was Alchemist actually banned last game? I didn't notice.
I don't recall. I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm.
Some teams like him, some teams don't. But the Nightstalker being banned first by Team Bulgaria here. I think it's Hawkeye. He's like sad. He was like, yeah. Can you ban Nightstalker? That hero owned me. Last game, he was like, he saw me. He silenced me. Radiant, I couldn't do anything. He earned me, so I couldn't blink. So he was like, ban that hero, please. And they did. So I think that's going to make it a bit better for Hawkeye if he plays a blink hero again.
It was also the first pick from Denmark in the last game. So clearly Denmark have a lot of priority with that hero. They really want to just have that point-click silence, have that even as a supporting hero in the last game, have that active hero that can roam around, get those kills. And it's going to force Denmark's hand slightly into something different, but it's probably just going to be these, you know, run-of-the-mill powerful heroes. Which combination they get, of course, is still up in the air. Ember Spirit is the start for Denmark, and we're seeing so much more Ember Spirit nowadays. This is actually going to mean that the Nightstalker ban kind of works in their favor. Nightstalker great versus that Ember.
Yeah, I like the Ember pick a lot. And let's see what their combo with. I'm a bit unsure. I think they should pick up a support right now. Earthshaker is still in the pool.
Mm-hmm.
I really think they want to get a really strong hero here that maybe deals with Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern has the Cold Embrace, so you want at least one hero that can really destroy that. And Quinnipain is one of the heroes that does that. I was thinking maybe even pick up Skywrath Mage now, so you just throw ultimate as soon as the Cold Embrace comes out.
No physical damage taken, but a hell of a lot of magic damage. And, well, Queen of Pain, not exactly that Skywrath Mage, but probably a little bit more consistent as far as her performance in the game. And as you said, does cut through almost entirely the Winter Wyvern's Embrace. So, yeah, for Team Denmark, they have as much of a counter as you can probably get versus the Winter Wyvern. Obviously, you're still going to have the Embrace to heal from time to time. But, Queen of Pain, Ember Spirit, most likely it's going to be Queen of Pain mid, safe play and Ember Spirit. They have, I guess, a little bit of flexibility to switch that up just a bit, but more often than not, that's how it's going to be. And for Dota 2 Bulgaria now, I mean, Winter Wyvern is, you know, one of those heroes that doesn't really show any of how their draft is going to progress. So they really just have the pick of the litter, but they're up against two very mobile heroes, so crowd control effects, point click silences, going to be at a premium. Maybe even the Skywrath Mage for their own.
Yeah, I think something that could maybe get some pickoffs, some ganking heroes would be nice. They banned the Darkseid though, so Darkseid and Wyvern is a pretty good combo. It's not the ganking lineup that I talked about, but it's pretty stable, and Darkseid is just so strong in lane, like just throw iron shells and you don't do anything else, and you just destroy the safe lane. Like the supports can't pull because the lane is pushing way too hard, and the safe lane has to buy extra regen, and not all heroes can deal with Darkseid, so it's a pretty nice hero, and a lot of teams are banning it early, and it's going to be Tusk. Can gank to an extent, doesn't have that the mid-game potential though to kill Ember and Queen of Pain. With a blink, he can set up, but he needs some nice follow-up, and Winter Wyvern is not really enough damage to kill his heroes. But still a nice hero to pick up. They played it, it was Denmark who played it offline last game, so they did not have access to that hero.
Getting the double cold heroes here for Dota 2 Bulgaria. It's not exactly the best hero to have if you're looking to like gank the likes of Queen of Pain or an Ember Spirit. Radiant, I mean, Snowball Walrus Punch is fine, but actually landing it when they can just jump away is not exactly the crowd control effects that they want. But still, having that in the middle of those fights, having that flexibility defensively with the Tusk is definitely valuable, especially up against that Quap, who Winter Wyvern's defensive power isn't really great up against, as we already mentioned, but Tusk Snowball, just no, you're not going to get any of those kills. And for Queen of Pain, Ember Spirit to blink in, thinking that they can get some kills, and then instantly they lose their targets because of the Snowball, feels real bad, man. Rubick, Bane now, we got a lot of these kind of very heavy utility supports being banned out by Bulgaria. And, I mean, yeah, Team Denmark, They only need their supports right about now, but
Reserve
not
time.
going to be that Rubick or Bane. Maybe they're trying to set up Bulgaria for an Earthshaker pickup with that ban on the Rubick.
Yeah, I was a bit surprised by the Rubick ban. In general, I think the Rubick is a very weak hero, especially when I am an offlaner. When I see Rubick, I'm like,
Radiant
nice, a weak
team.
support. I can kill him in lane or anything like that. It's pretty bad in early game. But if you want to pick up something like Earthshaker or Clock, I think Rubick is one of the heroes that are strong against those two. Stealing Fissure, and also in early game, Rubick can lift Clockwork out of cogs. So that's the two heroes I think that Bulgaria might be looking for. They had the Tusk already, so he can be run offlane. However, the hero can also be run as support, so
10
both of Clock and
seconds
Earthshaker are
remaining.
still viable for them. And Denmark, on the other hand, they really have to
Five
pick
seconds
up some
remaining.
supports themselves. Not too sure what they're looking
Reserve
for. There are
time.
some stable heroes like Witch Doctor. You can still pick up the Skye. He's very strong in lane also to deal with any hero. Other than that, it's gonna be a Lich. That's bit
Dire
surprising since they
Tangle.
haven't picked up usually Lich is dual offlane, but they haven't picked up a hero that's really strong in a dual offlane. It could be Quap, but it's not really the go-to hero to put up with Lich.
Yeah, I mean, it is a kind of a safe non-commitment hero here for Team Denmark. Lich, as I said, usually in that dual offlane, but really in any scenario is going to give your lane quite the significant edge.
10
That being
seconds
said, I'm
remaining.
not really sure how much I like Lich pickup
Windranger
like
at
right
your
here. It is going to
service.
be, you know, pretty good versus the Windranger, so that
Radiant
turns out to
team
be
pick.
pretty darn good as far as the ice armor is concerned. But yeah, I feel like they probably could have waited a little bit to grab this Lich. I think Witch Doctor is probably a little bit of a safer pick. Like, the fact that Lich has a lot of damage is nice, but he doesn't have a stun. And now they might need a couple stuns to deal with this Windranger. So, yeah, there are, of course, upsides and downsides with this Lich, but maybe they're trying to juggle their lanes a little bit, because Lich Queen of Pain
10 seconds
as a dual
remaining.
lane is actually fairly dangerous if Team Bulgaria don't
Five
have, you
seconds
know, the
remaining.
best of safe lanes. And support Winter Wyvern is a decent start, but you can't really trade hits with a Quap,
Reserve
especially a
time.
Quap with the Lich behind her.
Yeah, I think the winner on the pick was really good. I hope Denmark picks something very. I hope they pick Quap for mid or safe lane and Ember for the mid or safe lane counterpart, and then pick a really interesting offlane here. I want to see some more interesting picks. So far, it's been the Mirana last game was pretty interesting. Didn't work out though, but I really want to see something not necessarily new, but something a bit different that works out this game. And I think Lich plus one is the place where you can really try and be creative.
Like Legion Commander type heroes,
It can
like,
be pretty much anything. It's
yeah.
just it can be like it doesn't have to be a standard offlaner at all. It can be like, hey, just pick a hero that you have played before. Like maybe they have a strategy, like something that maybe is good against these heroes that I can't necessarily come up with. But just with Lich plus one, you can pretty much run any hero as offlane, and as long as it's good against the heroes, it doesn't really matter. He's not really an offlaner normally, so I would like to see something there. But either way, you can just run normal. Maybe put Quap Lich
10
there or a
seconds
normal offlaner
remaining.
plus Lich. But I really want to see something interesting in these
Crystal
games.
Maiden.
Well, I think there's
Dire
a very low
team pick.
percentage chance that it's going to be a Lich Crystal Maiden dual lane. That seems a little bit weak to me, but hey, we got a CM. Ember Spirit, Queen of Pain. Definitely heroes that can
Reserve time
accelerate quite a bit
remaining.
given a little bit more mana
Radiant team
regeneration.
ban.
But I mean, they have the Frostbite versus the Windranger, and that in of itself is pretty good. These supports, I mean, Lich and Crystal Maiden can do pretty well in an aggressive fashion, but you know, CM generally just wants to play it a little bit slower, get that jungle farm up, and now Bulgaria gonna grab the Undying.
10 seconds
They're gonna step up the pressure
remaining.
pretty hard right now. And as far as holding down the fort, Lich does okay in
Five
lane, but
seconds
can't really get
remaining.
into a giant fight. Same thing for Crystal Maiden. If Bulgaria just turned up the aggro dial to maximum right now,
Five
I don't know
seconds
if
remaining.
Team Denmark will be able to hold against that.
Yeah, I think they have
Dire
strong lanes. They
team
could deal
ban.
with it. It's gonna be.
Four.
Brood Ban is pretty good. I think that would be one of the
Radiant
heroes that could
team
really
pick.
mess with Team Bulgaria's lineup. They could put the Lich, Crystal Maiden, and safe lane supports, and you really
Reward
starve.
Horn of
It's gonna be
Might.
Magnus. I wonder how they're gonna
Dire
lane
team
this. Like I
pick.
said, I think Lich Quap could be around dual off lane. I'm not too sure about Lich Magnus though. It feels like a pretty mediocre lane there. It's Magnus isn't really a lane dominator. However, it could definitely be in. Like I said, Lich plus one always works. Doesn't really matter what hero it is, as long as it's a good pick for you. The hero in itself, it's good enough. They could run Magnus mid, but against Windrunner, it's probably
Ten
not gonna be
seconds
too strong.
remaining.
So Denmark's lane's gonna be a bit
5 seconds
bit interesting to
remaining.
watch. Maybe gonna be a bit too weak, possibly, even though they have a Lich.
Reserve
We'll see. The
time.
last pick from Bulgaria gonna be looking for the safe laner, I think, and I don't think they're too sure either about Denmark's lane, so they might be hesitating a lot on a certain hero that they were thinking about.
Well, the upside here for Team Denmark is that they've kind of stumbled into, I mean, they've picked in a roundabout way into like a giant wombo combo team. You don't have the Darkseer, which is usually
Seconds
like the linchpin
remaining.
in that, nor the Gyrocopter, but that's gonna be the pick for Team Bulgaria. They also do have the acceleration with the cleave on the Ember Spirit, so it's like Battle Fury plus half Battle Fury, or I guess, you know, better Battle Fury and half Battle Fury with the Magnus and Power. So that can get pretty ridiculous when you're RPing people. You have Sonic Wave, Chain Frost, like, yeah, real ridiculous things happening. For Bulgaria, it's kind of again, another non-commitment hero. Gyrocopter is, in this case, probably one of the safest heroes that they could have picked up, and that's really what you want to do if you don't know what the enemy lanes are going to be like. You want to grab a hero that is going to do decently pretty much all of the time. And, well, Gyrocopter versus any given lane from Team Denmark shouldn't really be having a struggle.
No, I think the pick was quite nice. Not necessarily the greatest pick, but since you're a bit unsure, it's okay, if not even better. And I don't feel like it's too strong against Denmark's lineup, though. He's not really a hero that can go in and kill anyone easily. Hop and Ember are pretty hard to really catch. However, the five-man lineup and pushing towers is really strong. Windrunner can take the towers down. With the Vivian is also pretty good. Just call and Brace a creep and you can tank it. And then just Undying for the when Denmark tries to defend. And same with Gyro is really good. When people try and defend the towers, he's really strong there. And but other that's the where Bulgarian lineup really excels at. And but if they're not that good at picking people off and really killing them. And we were gonna TP to lane. He did his last game, I think, on the Husker. He buys a TP as a carry and TPs out to see if the opponent wards. Very interesting. And I'm a big fan of just TPing level 1 in general, so I'm a big fan of this.
Man, so weird. Like a couple patches ago, if you see this happening, you're like, "What the hell is going on? I don't know what's happening." But now, like, TPs are cheaper, and well, just gotta make sure that your lane is safe. So they're going to place a pretty offensive observer and a blocking sentry. At least Hawkeye will. Still has a lot of gold at his tusk. Just wanted to get out of there. He's gonna swap positions here with Stominen, who was support last time. He's gonna be on the Undying this time. We got Hawkeye on the tusk. Nowhere is going to be handling the mid Windranger, and Pure Evil's on the Winter Wyvern up towards top lane. It is going to be the Gyrocopter, and it looks like there may be a Lich lane involved in this top lane with maybe a CM. She has boots first.
30 seconds to battle. Yeah, Eve's on the Crystal Maiden, heavy boots here. I'm not too sure what she's been gonna try and do. Maybe it's looking like a tri lane up here. I'm not too sure about it, though. I'm not a big fan of this, I think. I guess it works. Korean Zombie on the Lich with Fearless on the Ember, and Fury's gonna play mid on Magnus. I think that's okay. And then KSP are gonna be safe lane on the Quap. I think these lanes are okay. I'm a bit, it's a bit weird that they're running this offensive tri lane, but I hope can stand against this strong dual lane pretty nicely. Get experience, maybe not good farm, but a decent farm probably. And but even facing this dual lane, I think from Bulgaria, if they rotate up Tusk, that's gonna be a very strong tri lane you're facing with these kind of weak heroes, in my opinion, from Denmark offensive tri lane.
We can already see this Queen of Pain kind of struggling. Is probably not going to die here unless she makes a mistake and gets hit with a snowball. That's really the only scenario where I see her going down. But still, decaying a hero who is already not that tanky, has less than 400 max HP. It's going to be a very delicate game for this Queen of Pain. Ives is actually going into the enemy jungle as Crystal Maiden, which is, again, what Crystal Maiden kind of wants to be doing. You just want to be playing that supporty, jungly type role. In the enemy jungle or in your own jungle, I guess it really doesn't matter. As long as you're not going to be running into any enemies, this Crystal Maiden's going to get a decent amount of experience. And now we do actually have a full-on tri lane up towards top. They're going to leave the Tusk down towards bottom, have the Undying going up against these two heroes, the Ember Spirit and the Lich. And now this aggressive lane from Denmark, even though they do have a Lich still, is looking a little bit more rough.
Yeah, very weird lanes here. And if Ember can farm here, I think it works out. But he is already down to 100 HP with a full HP of max HP of 400 because of decay. And if they can put pressure on other lanes, maybe Crystal Maiden rotates mid a bit. I think putting Ember in this dual offlane is okay. He's a hero that wants form, but he necessarily doesn't need it. He can do okay with just his spells, they're pretty strong. But he needs experience then, and he really needs other lanes to dominate them. But Korean Zombie is gonna take a lot of damage here, and I think he might even go down. There's no boots on Gyro though.
Rain from the Wyvern, not quite high enough. The burn though is gonna go onto the Ember Spear instead. That's probably a little bit better. They'll get the kill on the Ember. It's Korean Zombie, yeah, you got away, and he probably maybe would have died also if the chains didn't catch up on Pure Evil, but hey, they get the Ember Spear instead. That's much better for Team Bulgaria. This is the power of Undying versus more than just one hero in lane. Like, now with three stacks of decay, not only is he hitting hard, but you don't have any HP on the Denmark side, so I don't really know if that's going to tell them they should be leaving this lane alone and trying to dissolve this into something else, but already we can see the Ember Spirit not exactly super survivable up against what Bulgaria have, even with like no Rocket Barrage damage involved in that kill at all.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about him TPing up here again, though. I feel like they should abandon this dual lane, but he's going to head up here again, and I think he's going to have a very hard time dying. Like, that was so bad. He saved Lich, of course, but that's not what you want to have happen trading. Just dying instead of your support is
mid.
It's pretty bad.
Nowhere. He's gonna get pushed back into the enemy tower. He will fall just to the right clicks. They saw the Crystal Maiden come in, but Windranger, for whatever reason, not backing off in time. Yeah, the Undying was like stalking the Crystal Maiden. He was right behind her. She knew that she was spotted, but she still got the Frostbite off. Magnus gonna get a little bit help versus the Windranger. Should have an okay lane pretty much all the time up against this matchup, but still Denmark get a kill that they probably shouldn't be getting over in this mid lane.
Yeah, that kill was pretty damn big. It's gonna mean Magnus has an okay mid lane. Can Baller Crawl now, gonna be a ruin in 40 seconds. And the safe lane is going amazing. Quap is destroying this Tusk, which is to be expected. He's out of mana now, so he won't have any more losses. He's like done. He has the D7 and getting maybe one more two is okay, but he won't get any real losses. And Quap will just free farm. But you're still sacrificing your Ember, and if he gets okay farm, it's fine, but this is so risky from them. Sacrificing their number one hero, position one hero, to try and go up against a Gyro Trilane with Undying. It's, I'm still not sure about it, even though it's 4 minutes in and it's been working out okay. If we disregard the kill, it's going really well for them. But I feel like they have to ride it out soon.
They're getting quite a decent amount of farm in the Ember Spirit, though. Here comes the Splinter Blast. Again, Gyrocopter not quite fast enough to get in close to the Ember Spirit to actually threaten lethal damage, but you know, the Ember Spirit's keeping up with the Gyrocopter, which is kind of weird. I would expect the Gyrocopter to have a little bit closer to like the Windranger's amount of farm, or at least the Ember Spirit to have a little bit less. I feel like for Denmark, these lanes, especially having this like kind of risky play in the Queen of Pain, the solo lane, or the Queen of Pain priority in the farm, is actually working out pretty well for them because the Ember Spirit somehow is still getting that farm. This is, of course, due in large part because they have a Lich on their side, but Team Bulgaria right now not really able to keep control of their lanes as much as they would really want to. This hard camp, I believe the sentry on the right side blocks it, could have been, you know, the difference in this lane if they were able to double pull.
Yeah, could have been really good, so that was some nice... Actually, this was just their own sentries, yeah. Mm-hmm. My bad, I assumed it was the opponent, so that's a bit weird.
I gotta assume that there was an enemy ward here, like, beforehand,
yeah,
and they
I guess
accidentally it blocked it again.
Yeah, I'm not too sure. Either way, Tusk bought a smoke. I thought it was gonna rotate up to top lane. I was like, gonna be... This is a really good smoke purchased by Tusk. He can rotate the top lane and really kill this Ember again. It's pretty easy. Then he TPs down to the bottom lane to get bullied again by Quap.
Yeah, the Tusk, I mean, he's getting a good amount of experience here, but he's just not keeping up with this Queen of Pain. Can't threaten the Queen of Pain either. And we can already see the struggle up on this top lane that the Ember Spirit is doing just fine. And ooh, now here comes the Queen of Pain. She has level 6, so Sonic Wave up and available. And she was not spotted by any observers, but Hawkeye, seeing no Queen of Pain in this next creep wave, may figure out what's going on.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Copia's deepest to top lane. Kind of panic, I'd say. This, of course, you want to gank top, but you can't just TP and just stand there and wait. Now Tusk is getting free farm. He has called out that Copia is missing. Everyone is playing passive. This is a big waste of time. And it's not like Denmark themselves are getting anything really on the lanes because there's a Kop missing. The Bulgarian team might be playing passive, but not that passive. They are still standing in lanes, knowing that the Kop is missing. They know which heroes can survive and which can not, which can't. So, however, Windrunner has to go back right now.
And one more power shot for the road. Fall back nowhere. There's a lot of heroes right above you. Well, she does have backup in Stoneman, and they kind of want to go for Fury because he is just looking so appealing right now. But it's a bad move from Nowhere. Throws out another power shot. Undying should be able to get the kill, and he will. But now Nowhere's in a little bit of trouble. Sonic Wave should get this kill unless you miss it. Nice shackle shot here from Nowhere. Sonic Wave is no longer lethal damage. Now here comes the Winter Wyvern. Splinter Blast is there. No blink for 3 seconds. They'll work down the Queen of Pain. Level 2 Shackle, what an angle. And now they're on to Ives. Is there another Shackle? There is. Oh, not enough mana to get it out in time. And that is going to be 2 kills for Bulgaria. You know, it's pretty slick power shots for sure from Nowhere, but the Shackle shot stole the show. And again, you were just saying that they knew that the Queen of Pain was off the map. You see the Ember Spirit now taking her place. They were kind of ready for her.
Yeah, there was a very, like, that rotation was so forced by Pop. And it was so obvious at the same time, so they, what a waste, I feel like. And I think Gyro should know that there's gonna be a possibility of a Kop rotating up here, because she died and she can TP out. And he's playing accordingly, very nicely played by him. And I feel like Denmark just had, this Kop was the one to take control of this game, and then did bad decision, and it just turned horrible, losing people in mid, and the Windrunner getting really big there, top net worth right now with 300, even 400 above the Magnus. And Kop is getting some okay lost hits, but Ember might be going down here on bottom lane.
Yeah, the snowball into War's Punch is enough duration to burst down the soft hero, though. The supports are actually looking for someone else. They're looking for the Crystal Maiden right now. They don't see her on the map, and usually you could expect she's jungling, but no, she's just chilling down on the bottom lane as kind of backup for the Ember Spirit, but even if they do jump the Ember Spirit, Crystal Maiden can't really help. Maybe contribute a couple attacks towards the Tombstone, but once that Tombstone drops, the Ember Spirit's got to just book it. Pure Evil does not have his ultimate just yet. They're going to straight up Walrus Punch him. Snowball's there as well. He did get a Spirit out. He's going to jump to it, but Ives dropping so low at the in the meantime. The Tombstone is a little bit too far away. Stoneman's going in for this one. He'll get interrupted out of his TP. Now the Sonic Wave onto two. Pure Evil will try to heal himself. He'll get blasted down by the Lich. Here comes the missiles. One Korean Zombie Hawkeye will teleport out. But that was a very awkward dive there for Team Bulgaria. And they're also going to lose the Wind Ranger. Fury grabs that kill by himself. What? Okay, that was a disaster.
Yeah, now he's 2.5k gold. He can easily pick up the Blinkist and what he decides to go, which I think it is. I doubt he would go for anything else. Maybe he goes very greedy and buys Boots of Travel or something, which I would not advise. But he should be picking up an item soon. The deaths on bottom lane were really bad, but Windrunner is maybe arguably even worse.
Mm-hmm.
I think that they should have secured that kill. I think Hawkeye, again, could have eye shot further down so that when Ember jumps to his remnant, the eye shot is still locking him in instead of going for only the damage on eye shots. I think it was a pretty big mistake, and I think they lost the kill mainly because of it. And now another wasted smoke on them as well. So, Bulgarian team really getting a big advantage because of a misrotation from Kop and then kind of throwing it back to Denmark, I feel like. And Magnus has the potential to take control of this game now.
And the supposed trade-off for getting this Queen of Pain all this farm is that their Ember Spirit is supposed to be behind, but he's keeping up very well with the Gyrocopter. He's only 100 behind. Gyrocopter did teleport down to the bottom lane as well. Got a call down out, but that's pretty much it. So he wasted a lot of time where he could have been farming up on the top lane to just get not that much done on bottom. The trade-off for Denmark was not really punished, and Magnus, not like crushing the lane, but has his Blink Dagger 10 minutes in, and this is probably as good as you would expect from this mag. They're going to jump in for Nowhere this time. Shockwave is going to be thrown. They need to back off. There's one too many TPs, and they will, I guess, protect their Wind Ranger, but Denmark just rotating in with a Lich and Crystal Maiden don't really expend that much to force out those TPs.
I wasn't sure. I thought the power shot was to cancel the Magnus Blink, but it didn't get cancelled. So I'm not sure why it didn't Blink kill Winona. I think it was an easy kill, and he might have been afraid of dying afterwards, but you can skewer him kind of far away into Lich. He just pops everything. He just kill the Windrunner. There's no reason to not do it.
Round They're 2 maybe? Blink RP got him! And he's going to skewer him right back into the Lich, and he's going to pop everything. Well, there you go. It's, yeah. They heard you. And that was, it looked like right on the edge of that RP range, but yeah, Windranger gonna get nailed down again. And now this lane for Windranger is, I mean, not completely inhospitable, but the Blink Dagger on Magnus ups his kill power by so much. Like, Blink RP is a one thing, Blink Skewer is another. There's so many things you have to play around as the Windranger. You have to keep yourself out of Blink range, and that is, like, what, the 1,000-something distance? They're gonna try to go for the Queen of Pain down towards bottom lane, but snowballing straight into her, Shard's gonna miss. Not gonna happen.
Yeah, really a desperate attempt there, Undying committing Tombstone, which is a big spell to commit as well for a very low chance of getting that kill. So Bulgaria here losing a bit of momentum, really nicely played, like I said, in mid lane, and they did it, but they committed Magnus RP, which I think wasn't needed in the previous attempt, but whatever, it doesn't matter, they got the kill that they wanted. And it's not really gonna cost them anything. RP is gonna be up in a minute. It's probably not gonna be affected. But when I say that, Bulgaria, the Bulgarian team here rotates all five bottom and probably gonna take this tower. So I think Denmark should just split push now. I think they can afford to lose this tower. They don't really want to fight without the RP, and they can maybe even take one or even two towers here as a trade.
They see everyone coming in. They see the gyrocopter attacking the tower. They have an observer ward, spotting the other two heroes behind them. And now the race is on. Nowhere does have focus fire. He's not gonna... Okay, there it is. He can use it right now. So this tower is definitely going to fall. Mid lane, dropping to below half HP. Top lane, around the same thing. Fortifications on both sides. And, well, the Radiance tower will fall first. Where are Team Bulgaria going to defend? Are they going to defend at all? They have a wraparound on the Undying in a really good spot behind the enemy. He's going to drop the Tombstone. Korean Zombie's the one in trouble here. He's going to be chased down by regular zombies. A little bit of help from the Queen of Pain, but that was, again, a really weird Tombstone. I guess it's like a get-off-my-tower type Tombstone. They do get the tower deny. Up towards top lane, the tower also is going to be in deny range, though, again, fortifiable because of the Tier 1 dropping. Looks like the Ember Spear should be able to get this one without too much of an issue.
Yeah, so you traded one tower to get a deny and lose a tower, which is not really what you want. And now RP is up, and I think Denmark, if they want to, they can fight right now. Magnus is on top lane, though. A bit surprised he wasn't already prepared in mid lane to initiate. I think, looking at Denmark's lineup right now, they have, like, look at their team fight potential. If there's a Freeman RP, three people will die instantly. Quop, Sonic Wave, Lich Ultimate, even Crystal Maiden has skilled the Freezing Feed at level 6. And their team fight potential is incredible. And Bulgaria's squad here really has to play well, I feel like, to even have a chance at having a team fight here and taking the tower.
Magnus is coming around from behind with an Invis rune. They're going to dive forward a little bit for this Lich, but Magnus has the perfect opportunity right now. The positioning is there for 3-man RP. He's going to launch it. There's the 3-man. Chain Frost is going to be used immediately. Blink forward, scream. Well, they get saved with a little bit of time with the snowball. Calldown is there. Queen of Pain, Lich, both dead. And they'll also drop the Magnus. Here comes the Ember Spirit. Will pop the Gyrocopter. Now trying to go for nowhere. Freezing Field in the back lines, nowhere. Trying to run down to the south. Will fall to the Sleight of Fist from this Ember Spirit. Now we're going to fight up against Stoneman with the help of Iv. Stoneman is going to try to hide in his tombstone. It's not going to happen. He'll die, giving a triple kill to the Ember Spirit. That looked, you know, pretty good for Bulgaria, considering they didn't get instantly obliterated by that combo of Denmark. But Ember Spirit coming in, cleaning house, ended it up still pretty bad for Bulgaria in the end.
Yeah, Sonic Wave was not used. Mm-hmm. That's why that fight was a lot more close than it should have been. I think that should have been a 5-0 team fight easily if the Sonic Wave came out. That would have been three people dead instantly, and then Ember wrapping around. Really nice wraparound from Ember, by the way, coming in and securing kills, which should have been two secured kills, but he secured all five kills because of a bit of a misplay from the Quop, I think. Maybe blinked a bit too close to Tusk, who's just snowballed. And however, didn't really matter. I think it's fine that they died. If Ember gets all the experience and form, I think that's completely fine. He's the position one here either way. Quop just want levels. His level 9 has the Yules. Doesn't really need that much more. And what you want is the Ember to be really fed.
Ooh, they also are going to find the Tusk right now. He can snowball for a little bit of time. It's going towards the Queen of Pain. But now where are you going to run? Nowhere. He's going to get slashed down by the Ember Spirit again. Now 4 kills to his name. And his Battle Fury is actually not too far away. And, well, on top of that Battle Fury, level 3 in power is up on the Magnus, who, you know, kind of got the perfect rune in that case. Though I'm pretty sure with any other rune, or even with no rune, he would have been able to get a very similar initiation there. Yeah, Denmark, they had a dual offlane Ember Spirit Lich, and now Ember Spirit's on top of the net worth chart. Maybe it would have been a little bit worse if Ember Spirit didn't collect all those kills if you just like awkwardly came in at the last second, but man, now they're in like a pretty commanding lead, and they're looking for nowhere. They see him farming. Crystal Maiden kind of slow to initiate though. Nowhere is not going to get out in time. Here comes the Frost. Frostbite is there after the Nova. Blink forward, skewer right into the Lich, and with the Shockwave, that's one dead Windranger. Hawkeye's here, gonna try to go for this Crystal Maiden. They may just leave her for dead. It's already a good trade for Denmark. There's no sense sticking around with Korean Zombie as well. Frostbite is there. Backup is the Magnus with an RP available, but Ibs is already dead, so now it's time for Korean Zombie to just book it. And it looks like he'll be just fine. Nothing that they have is going to catch up. But, ooh, we have a double damage Ember Spirit. He's going to chain down Stoneman, and this is super dangerous. He's going to two-shot him with the Shockwave. The missiles are going to fall into Korean Zombie, and the Ember Spirit both slow them down. But, man, it's another free kill, although somehow the Magnus was the one to steal that one. Ember Spirit not quite at his Battle Fury just yet, but is doing so much damage with the Empower. Tusk is right around the corner, has no Snowball, however. Cannot get on top of this Ember Spirit, even if they do. He has a backup Remnant across the river.
Yeah. That double damage for him just destroying people. I think they could have maybe even picked up Gyro, but nice calls from Denmark as well. They realized when they killed Windrunner, I think they could actually lose like three heroes there, Denmark, with the. But they like, okay, CM is dead. We're gonna sacrifice us, just gonna run into the enemy base and just space crate, and we're not gonna lose anymore. And then they got another kill also thanks to it. It was really nicely coordinated from Denmark's team, and nowhere here on the winner is in a bit of a bad situation. Isn't really close to the Aghanims at 80 minutes. It's not gonna be the latest Aghanims I've ever seen, probably, but it's not looking like even mediocre timed one at this point.
Well, really, no matter what time you get your Aghanims as a Ranger, you're going to be doing some damage, but she's really losing that window where you get the Aghanims and then you immediately start snowballing out of control because you're able to get a couple kills, then get like a Blink Dagger or Force Staff or some sort of mobility item, land Shackle Shots right after. Korean Zombie walking up for some reason, but the Shards again missing. Now the Tusk is kind of far away. The Walrus Punch up the Lich. He has the mechanism, so he's not going to die anytime soon. Hawkeye is alone right now. The rest of the... Oh, nice two-man Shackle Shot. Power Shot onto two Shards as well. It will not damage the Lich, and looks like the Queen of Pain is going to get out of there. CM going to teleport away from Stoneman, and that was super awkward, but no one's going to die.
Yeah, it looked like one hero on either side could have went down if that went a bit different, but look what the Rune Magnus has.
How does he keep on finding them? I don't know. Yule Scepter is there. They drop Sentry, so they know exactly where Fury is. Blink forward into the curse. Can they kill him off in time? The Shackle fails to land. He does have a skewer out, but he's taking so much damage from the Focus Fire. He'll get a short skewer. It's not going to do enough. They also lose the Queen of Pain. However, here in the back lines, it's Ibs channeling up that ultimate. They do see her, and the Wind Ranger will grab her for a triple kill. The Ember Spirit has pieced on out of there, and it is going to be a 2-for-4 exchange. Blinking right into the curse like that. Not the plan of the Magnus, but it's just Team Bulgaria to have the right Sentry at the right time.
Yeah, I wonder if he doesn't realize they put a sentry and he thinks Winter Wyvern has the maybe most insane reactions that a human can have. But the sentry went down, and nicely played from Bulgaria. I'm not sure if they knew that the sentry was down. I mean that he had an invest, but they played it safe and put it down just in case. They don't want to have the same thing happen. And they got four heroes. I think the Ibs on Crystal Maiden did a really nice play that secured two kills for him, and Ember was part of those kills as well, I think. So it wasn't that bad for Denmark. Ember's item progression is still going strong, and I think that's what's most important for Denmark, that he keeps getting items and that he, in late game, can just destroy people, pretty much.
Yeah, and the Sentry did double duty, like not only spotting out that Magnus, but also kind of countering the Crystal Maiden's Glimmer Cape, which otherwise would have just destroyed Team Bulgaria. We have a smoke up now. Fury has the Blink Skewer, level 2 Skewer. It seems like they want a little bit of a better position here. They're going to wrap around into their Roche Pit. I'm pretty sure they're not going to try this. It seems a little bit risky. Yeah, they're going to go towards mid lane instead. They still see nowhere. Oh, they see two right now. Blink, Skewer, RP, gonna catch two. Chain Frost is available. Blink forward. No Sonic Wave, but they don't even need it. Nowhere is gonna get embraced. And the Lich Chain Frost is not bouncing well at all. Here comes the missile. KSPR getting a little bit too close. Will be forced to blink away as Ibs is gonna get dropped. In a 1-for-1 exchange, Korean Zombie slowed down, has popped the mech, but he'll get obliterated shortly after. Ember jumps away. And that was a little bit of a weird play there, trying to initiate that far ahead of the backup with no Sonic Wave at that.
Yeah, it looked good, but then with the Vive and with the Colibris on Windrunner, and then there's almost no damage follow-up. It's only co-op with medical damage, and without ultimate, he doesn't do that much. It's just a scream, and if he had Sonic Wave, sure. Oh, that's actually a dead Windrunner. I think the Shackle is gonna latch, though. Doesn't matter.
I love those like really short melee range skewers just stamping over that Windranger. Yeah, the Ember Spirit is surviving these fights. He's 4-1-4, has his Battle Fury completed, with, of course, maxed out in power, so his farm rate and his damage in these fights is going to be absolutely insane, with or without Sonic Wave. And, you know, Queen of Pain getting that kill participation on there on that Windranger is not too far away from the Ags in this game. I'm actually kind of surprised that she went for that Yule Scepter. Usually it's just, like, in direct response, like a Global Silence or a Skywrath Mage, but nothing really that's, like, absolutely pressing to get the Yule Scepter for in this game.
I like Yule Scepter a lot on co-op in general. It's like a cheaper BKB and you can use it aggressively. It's not as good in certain situations, but sometimes it's better even. And I'm not too sure about this game, but I think when you're safe lane and you don't want to get bottled, I think you kind of have to go Yules.
Mm-hmm.
So you get some mana regen going, and also not as expensive as something like Orchid to get the mana regen. And a bit more multi-purpose, so I like this item in general, and Aghanim's afterwards, you get some tankiness as well. It's just a nice item overall, I think, and I think when you're playing like KSPR did in that situation, usually this is the build that you go for.
Radiant's top tower 7013 seems to be working out kind of okay for Denmark, the 137 score Queen of Pain. Her offensive power is kind of cut by the fact that she does have to work the very long cooldown on the Sonic Wave. The Ember Spirit can pick up the slack and just stole like a 2-3 stack of Ancients from the Bulgarian side with one Sleight of Fist, or like two Sleights of Fist with the obnoxious amount of cleave that he has. They're going to try to go for Roshan right now. Lifesteal on the Gyrocopter is going to make this pretty safe, and the Focus Fire on the Windranger is going to make it pretty fast. They do have wards absolutely freaking everywhere.
Yeah. It's going to be hard to go. I think there's a lot of content initiating power, so the Magnus is going to have a hard time getting a good RP here.
Walking a little bit too far in. Force Staff, Skewer, both of them, they're gonna get caught. RP is there, Sonic Wave on top, but that's about it. Fury, he's gonna grab the Aegis and kill off the Roshan. Big plays from Fury. He's gonna respawn, I think, with the Blink Dagger out. Now here comes the Ember Spirit, dropping Pure Evil super low. Fury not gonna get the Blink out instead, and he's just gonna get worked down by the guns. He's gonna throw a Shockwave towards nowhere, but he will fall in the end. Chain Frost now there. They gotta split a little bit better, but no, they do it very quickly in that. Ember Spirit still throwing out those Sleights of Fist, not doing enough. Now Korean Zombie's gonna hit with the Snowball. No, it's actually going towards the Ember Spirit with the Undying there. Walrus Punch is dodged. They lose the Magnus, but they get the Roshan. They don't get any kills afterwards, but still, that's a really big play for the Magnus, and I would say that it's worth it.
I think it's worth it as well. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty even exchange, I'd say. Gold Chain says it's in favor of Team Bulgarian, but I'm not sure if that counts in the gold you get from Roche.
I don't think it does.
Even if it does or whatever, it doesn't really matter. It was a pretty even fight overall, and I think Denmark are pretty happy with just losing Magnus to steal, to not let the opponents have Aegis either way, even if they maybe not even got a Roche kill. So they're pretty happy with that, and they just want Ember to get the late game. I feel like they're having some trouble dominating mid game, so they really have to look for late game. And Team Bulgaria has some potential in late game for sure, but I feel like some of the heroes might not be up to par. Undying is a bit weird though. Undying generally falls off late game, but with Aghanim's he doesn't anymore. He's so strong late game, so I'm not too sure how the late game is going to be anymore, because usually I would say Undying is pretty useless. Denmark's team is okay, Lich is pretty good late game. CM can be good, not always, but Magnus, Ember, Popper are three good, while Bulgaria only have Gyro and Windrunner. But this Undying is a bit of a unknown factor with the new Aghanim's upgrade. Can be really sick even late game.
He's going to have to actually get a lot of farm to get that. He may just want to go for Guardian Greaves, protect himself a little bit from this CM and Lich combo. I think you could also purge off the chains if that is ever going to be relevant for him. But yeah, for the Undying, he doesn't exactly farm super quickly, and he's very far away from that Ags. And well, this is not a super big ancient stack. In fact, it's just a single. It's going to be stolen by the Ember Spirit. The heroes are coming in. Hawkeye, he does see him, and
oh,
Ember
they're
Spirit
in the
is...
Ends.
Yeah, he doesn't have a Remnant, actually. He needs some help. He's going to jump short down to the low ground. Call down is there. Going to connect onto two. Korean Zombie is going to get the mech out, and he will turn around for the Chain Frost. Bouncing between Stoneman will get absorbed a lot by these zombies. Now the curse onto this Ember Spear. Can they bring him down? They will. Chain Frost still bouncing, but it will ultimately not kill off anyone. Man, if you're going to make that play, if you're going to go so deep into the enemy Ancients, you got to have a backup Remnant.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about that play. Even what happened, he got out. Like, he was out. He doesn't have to fight. And then he could have used his second Remnant to get out again. Like, there's no point in standing. They lost Lich. There's no way they're winning that fight. Magnus can't blink. He has zombies chasing after him. I don't even know if Kopp was close. I don't really know why Ember dies there. It's pretty pointless, and I really think he could have easily survived that if he realized the threat that was coming towards him. And Lich also throwing the ultimate. I feel like that's not what you want either. He kind of makes his team think that they can teamfight by throwing that ultimate. And he should really not use it at all, because it's a pretty long cooldown, and it's just going to be wasted there. And so I'm a bit sad about Denmark's approach in that teamfight. I think they could have lost Lich and been done with it. There's no objectives that the Bulgarian team can get, and they can split farm a lot better, I feel like, with the Ember and Kopp.
Lich is an entirely expendable hero here for Team Denmark, so throwing him to the wolves so that your Ember Spirit can escape, that should be like a pretty standard play. It should be a play that they're actually like looking to make if it means getting the Ember Spirit out of harm's way. Sacrifice the Lich, go on ahead. And we do have the Guardian Greaves now up on the Undying, but still, Ember Spirit, after having gone down, still is very, very close to his Daedalus. And with the Empower, I don't know exactly how much he's going to be critting for, but it is going to be hurting like hell. As long as Bulgaria are not super clustered up, they should be fine. This is a very different game from last time, where they kind of wanted to be clustered up because they wouldn't be punished. This time, if they do, they're just going to get absolutely obliterated by the Aghanim Scepter Queen of Pain ultimate. Only level 2 at this stage, but soon to be level 3. Ember Spirit, of course, with Cleave and Magnus and CM. Like, it's all bad. And Magnus actually going to go for a Mystic Staff. Looks like he wants to get a Shiva's up on the board.
Yeah, it's the Sumail build. I think he went this. I'm not sure if he picked up boots or anything, but it's going to be a Shiva's, I'm pretty sure. And a big wraparound from Bulgarian team to find a Lich and a Tower, if even that.
Ooh, they're thinking about the Lich. They're going to put an Observer Ward to see any reinforcements. Lich,
I think they might be panicking now.
Yeah. They dropped the Tombstone. Lich is going to just book it. He's not teleporting out. Now he is, but it's way too late. He's going to cancel it and try to run. Good luck, Lich. Good luck. Chain Frost, how much damage is it going to do? Well, doesn't even get
a CS. Didn't even get a loss hit. What a waste of a Chain Frost, I feel like. Now, when he spawns in 40 seconds, the teamfight potential is a lot less. I'm not too sure about why he's using those when he's going down. There's no point at all. Like, he doesn't do any damage. Everyone is full HP. He didn't even get the losses on the range creep that they bounced on, so complete waste, I feel like. And that means Bulgarian's push here is a lot stronger, even. Because there's no Sonic Wave plus Lich ultimate that can destroy them. And same as ultimate is a bit less unreliable, I think. It's easy to cancel, and it's pretty hard to get in position where it can be really effective.
That was still all five heroes from Bulgaria going for that. And Lich's ultimate, it does have a pretty large cooldown, but it's no black hole, so in 60 seconds he'll have that up again, and that should be, you know, by the time Bulgaria are going to want to make a fight happen, if they actually do want to fight at all. So it seems like that Chain Frost, I mean, again, it didn't really do jack, but still, it's not going to be at least super punished. If they fought right now, then Lich is going to be really awkwardly positioned, but it looks like that's just not going to be happening. Bulgaria, they are definitely scared about approaching the team fight of Team Denmark, although Stoneman is going to see everyone drops a Tombstone. It's going to cut off Korean Zombie and Ives. This is not a good place for Lich to be. Maybe if he had Chain Frost here, but there's no good place to Chain Frost. He's going to try to kill off the Tombstone before he dies, but he will fall first. Call down in the back is going to catch first missile onto the Ember Spirit as Ives is going to try to sneak out of there with the Glimmer Cape. Looks like he will be successful. Yeah. So it's just Lich again to just get completely screwed over.
Oh, never mind. He's caught.
They caught him. Shackled. Power shot. Couple more right clicks. No focus fire needed, though they will use it in the end. It's a 2-kill here for Bulgaria. That opens the door for the push.
Yeah, I'm not too sure. I think they... two supports running off the D-ward like that is a bit of a mistake. They should just have Lich, who's pretty much useless here, just D-warding and having him baiting. And then Magnus can easily counter. Even if he just gets a one-man skewer, they blow that hero up and then they can just... they trade one for one And then they can wait until he has Blink Skewer again, and he can RP, or Bulgaria squad has to fall back pretty much. So, a bit weird plays by Denmark. It's not the biggest of deals. It costs them now a tower, and the Bulgaria squad got a lot of farm there. But if they don't do it again, it's not the biggest of deal. But if they keep doing plays like this, it's gonna be very painful because they are getting farm on the Winner and Gyro because of these steps.
I think it's the tower falling there for Denmark that really makes it sting a little bit more. They really do want to have as many Ancients available to this Ember Spirit as possible, and it's a little bit harder to actually lock that down when, well, first of all the paths towards the Ancients are spotted by the Dire. They have vision wards everywhere. But yeah, they just really want to have that presence in the secret shop, ancient jungle corner, whatever you want to call it, this area of the map. And it's a little bit harder now for them. So, I mean, losing the Crystal Maiden, losing the Lich, whatever. The Crystal Maiden's going to go for a BKB. Eventually, she'll have it, and Lich is nowhere close to his item. But, oh, what are you doing here, Ember Spirit? He's going to jump up to the high ground, jump across the river, try TP out.
Oh,
Nowhere's going to
no.
give chase. Focus Fire! It's enough damage! Oh, Ember Spirit just wanted to scout for Roshan, I think?
Yeah, I don't know, then I feel like they're playing so weird. They're making so much basic mistakes right now, and it's really costing them this. They had good control over this game. Looking at the XP and the gold, both graphs were like pretty high in favor of them, almost 7.5k in favor in gold. And it hasn't really been a team fight, and they still lost almost 10,000 gold now because of these minor mistakes that's really costing them. It's messing up to a lot, and now the Bulgaria team is just looking a lot stronger right now. Winon is very big, Gyrocopter is looking not unkillable but kind of close to it. In mid lane, the Undying might go down. He's pretty tanky.
Pop the Flesh Golem, gets a two-man decay. Zombies are stacking up, and here comes the Shackle. Cancel the TP and latch onto the Queen of Pain. Snowball through, they'll crush the Queen of Pain, and Ives will get Walrus Punch into the air. You don't mess with Undying, and you don't mess with Nowhere Shackle Shots, apparently. The Roshan is not up just yet for Bulgaria, but still, that should be a free pickoff on a quote-unquote support hero for Team Denmark. Instead, they just fall short, and they get punished as much as they can possibly be punished. But that the Crystal Maiden was fine. Thought Queen of Pain was screwed, but no, both of them to fall. Denmark, they haven't been getting these team fights, and that's, as you said, like they are pretty much like a team-fighting lineup at this point. As long as Team Bulgaria keep on getting those Shackle Shots and keep on getting those like small-scale engagements and avoiding the large 5v5s, well, we're going to see a lot more of this. A nosedive of net worth and experience into the Team Bulgaria's favor.
Yeah, I think this is we've reached a point where we can say it's full tilt mode for Denmark right now. They are just feeding heroes everywhere. They're going to lose Roche right now. And Ember's farm, it's not bad, but he's behind Gyro now. He's always been ahead, and now he's 2k behind. And he is a hero that, at this stage, he can, if he gets a nice crit or two, he can do a lot of damage. But the Frost Armor from, I guess he died to Roche, because Gyro had the frost crit that gives like plus 8 armor or something. Oh yeah, actually it's here, yeah. Which is really good against Ember. He does a lot less damage to everyone in your team because you can put it up on like 4 heroes, I think, or even 5. And Ember's items looks a lot less because of that. And I really think they have to rely on a big RP right now. Ember is not strong enough anymore. Corp is not strong enough anymore. Their heroes without RP are not strong enough anymore that I think they were before. They could play it around everything else and just not rely on a big RP. But at this point, you have to get a big RP if you want to win a team fight.
Well, I mean, it could be worse, right? They could have these teamfight ultimates to kind of fall back on. They have drafted themselves a really, really threatening high ground defense draft. So, you know, for Bulgaria to have this advantage is one thing. For them to actually win the game off this advantage is quite another. Everyone from Denmark are smoked up. I don't know where they popped the smoke. I assume it was in their base. But there's a chance that this was spotted by Bulgaria. But just looking at the Bulgarian positioning right now, like, your RP is going to land maybe onto these three heroes in the back if they were, like, right in position right away. But for Bulgaria, it's a pretty easy game plan. Like, everyone separates. No one get hit by an RP. Like, no more than two heroes at least. That should be the game plan for them, like at all stages in the game. If they cluster up a little bit too much, you could call that a mistake. But they kind of just like, for Denmark, have to land this RP, but it's like so hard to because Bulgaria know that that's the game plan. Like, obviously, RP is the only thing that you really want to avoid and the only thing you really can avoid easily.
Yeah, and even if there is a big RP, if Tusk is not in it, he can blink in, snowball, and save everyone. And like, if he puts everyone in snowball, like Lich ultimate, CM ultimate, Sonic Wave, everything can miss. So it's very hard. And if Tusk plays it correctly, it can. Even if the RP is big, it might not even matter. I think the smoke was envisioned, by the way. I think the Bulgarian team knows about this. So they're putting Undying and Winner with Aegis kind of in frontish and keeping all the heroes back. So Magnus does not have an easy initiation here at all.
Maybe you blink Skewer instead of blink RP. He's gonna catch only the Gyrocopter right now. He
Never
can't get his
that.
BKB off. Sonic Wave is there. They invest a lot to get him, but they don't even do it. Sorp's gonna bring him back up to full fury now. Lockdown. Ives is gonna get a pretty nice freezing field in the back lines. No one's actually canceling that, despite the fact that they do have vision, but it's just not enough. Windranger will lose the Aegis, but still the Gyrocopter's at like full HP. They'll chop down the Crystal Maiden. Ember Spirit gonna jump away afterwards. It's a 3-for-3 and Aegis. I think for Denmark, that was not the RP that they really wanted. But the Crystal Maiden stepped up and got an almost full channel, or I think it was a full channel of Freezing Field. And that was enough. So that was actually a really good hold from Denmark, even after a kind of a weird looking RP.
Yeah, I feel like Ives have several fights. He's been like the one that really salvaged the fight for Denmark here. Remember the previous fight on bottom lane? It was Ember and CM surviving, and CM was the one that really enabled them to get something in return, and same happened here. I think, again, Hawkeye didn't even use Snowball, a bit questionable play, I'd say. However, Gyrocopter, I thought it was a bad play by him, going up the line. He was sure, he was not gonna die there. He's so tanky, I underestimated how tanky he was. I think Denmark underestimated how tanky he was, and they blew everything on him, and he didn't. He lost like half his HP, and then he has half BKB, and even Helmut Dominator healed him up like 25% of his HP after that. And that was. He was unstoppable in that fight. Ember does not have the damage to deal with him. Sonic Wave is not enough, and he's going BKB, which is probably right on Queen of Pain, but they're lacking so much right now, and the only thing they have in their favor would be the RP, I think.
I mean, that is also a testament to how much damage Denmark can put out. In general, I guess. Like, they use everything on the Gyrocopter, don't kill him, but they also kill off everyone else. Like, if you use all of your resources to fail to kill off an enemy hero, usually you're not going to have enough to get all those kills afterwards, but somehow they do. And again, you can't really count on the Crystal Maiden to land that much Freezing Field damage in the next fight, but for this one fight for Denmark, no response onto this Crystal Maiden. I'm pretty sure there just wasn't. The Shackle Shot, there was definitely a Dire Sentry there, so they definitely saw the Crystal Maiden channeling, but I don't know, for the Bulgaria side, they just had to make sure to get an answer for the Crystal Maiden, and CM's really overperforming this game. Like, her net worth doesn't really show anything impressive, but she's level 14, and once this level 3 Freezing Field comes up with the BKB and the Glimmer Cape, like, what are you gonna do? You just gotta run or hope that she's an AoE for the Winter's Curse, but you don't really want to be cursing a Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, I think the only reason Denmark are in this game is because of the big ultimate from Crystal Maiden. Ives really performing, so far at least. And the rest of his team played well in early game, but we haven't seen anything big anymore. No Sonic, no big Sonic Wave, no big RP. Ember is playing good, no real faults. Lich has been playing a bit questionable as well, but I don't think it's affected his performance too much. I think he's been playing well in the fights, which is what matters. And there's a smoke up here, and they're gonna find Lich. And the rest of Denmark is pretty close though, this could be risky.
Nova the Gyrocopter, show off the CM's positioning, that is actually going to get the Lich back to safety. But right now, Bulgaria, they're so spread out, they're going to jump on the Crystal Maiden, no Freezing Field for this fight, not a chance. They also see the Ember Spirit jump up to the north, snowball forward onto the Korean Zombie. Hawkeye is all in right now, they will get help and will kill out the Lich. No response here for Denmark, everyone else is going to leave. Again, it's the loss of Lich and the loss of the Crystal Maiden. It could have been a lot worse since Team Bulgaria didn't know more or less where the Ember Spirit was. That would have been a disastrous fight. But still, they looked like they could have gone away for a little bit of that. But once the Crystal Maiden gets shackled there, it's just all over for her.
Yeah, it was pretty rough there. And they only lost two supports though. So it's not a big deal in this fight, but it's become too much at this point. It's been four or five times that they've just lost one or two heroes here and there, and it's really messed up to this big advantage for Bulgarian squad with now leading with 7.5k in gold, and experience is probably 5k almost, probably when it finished going down it's gonna be 5k advantage in experience as well. And the Blink Dagger on Ember, I like Blink Dagger on Ember in general, but I feel like they are close to being forced by Divine on him at this point. I think it's a bit risky to go Divine so right now, but if this game continues like this, he needs more items. He needs to do more damage. He's just tickling the cores of Bulgarian. Even Undying doesn't care that much. And Winter Wyvern is called Embrace. I'm feeling like he's lacking a lot, and I don't think Blink Dagger is a solution. It's up to Magnus now. It's only Magnus now, and because of this pickup, so I'm not a big fan of this Blink at all.
Maybe he figures I have a Magnus on my team with Empower, so I don't really need to go for that much extra damage. But generally, Blink Dagger on Ember Spirit's like the I'm ahead item, so I'm just going to get these items so that I can get these pickoffs and still do enough damage in these fights. But Denmark aren't really in a position where they can say, okay, that's 2,000 gold that the Ember Spirit's farmed up, drop that into a mobility item. He should be, at least in theory, mobile enough to get in there and get out without a problem. But yeah, I agree. I think I would rather like to see any given damage item. Hell, even like a... Well, I mean, obviously can't really compare Blink Dagger to an Eye of Skadi, but something like mixed survivability even for the Ember Spirit. Just this Blink Dagger gives absolutely no stats, gives no damage. I don't really think that's a item that Ember Spirit really wants to have at this stage, but who knows? I mean, he still has some power. He's still hitting for 300 damage a pop with crit and cleave. Double cleave, in fact, so it's like 85? Yeah, 85% cleave. He can still do a lot of damage even after this Blink Dagger, and looks like he will grab the tier 2 tower, rather, up on this top lane. Team Bulgaria, they're kind of just all spread out. They don't really want to fight. They'll let that tower drop.
Yeah, I guess this Blink Dagger is going to enable him to farm a bit quicker, but I feel like it's pretty mediocre still. We'll see if it works out, though. The other items on the teams are pretty lackluster. Crystal Maiden is getting closer to BKB. Magnus is a bit stuck right now. I don't think he has anything on Courier. He doesn't have any progress at all. Quop is having some progress. It's not big, but at least there's progress. Lich is not having any items. But on the other side, we see Undying just picking up the 4 stuff. Winner has 4k gold. Winter Wyvern has Gleaming Cape, 1.5k gold, also carrying a gem. Tusk has Deso, 2k gold as well. He has quite nicely set. And Garrokoth is just huge. The differences in items is pretty big, very significant. And who's gonna pick up? Kope needs going BKB now, and she needs like one more item before she's anything more than Sonic Wave. She's just a Sonic Wave right now, and BKB is not gonna change that. It might just make it a bit easier to get the Sonic Wave off, but she's gonna need another item somewhat soon because she's just falling behind the rest of the enemy team.
She needs like a sheep stick or like an Octarine Refresher type build. Really, it doesn't really matter at this point as long as she's doing extra damage. But BKB, I guess, enables you to do her damage, but at this point, just not enough. We have double BKBs now on the Bulgarian side. Windranger just grabs hers. So that huge freezing field that we've seen in the past from Ives, suddenly not as easy to land. They do have pretty decent tools like going through the BKB, but just not the freezing field. Oh, they're going to find KSPR right now. Yule Scepter, not even in time. You get put into a blender once you get hit with that Shackle Shot. Any given hero is going to dive to that, no questions asked. And the worst part is that Roshan is alive right now, so Bulgaria get probably one of the best pickoffs they can ask for in the Queen of Pain, yeah. And now they're going to grab Aegis and Cheese, probably for the Gyrocopter and Windranger in some sort of assortment, but there's no chance Denmark can actually defend this.
We'll buy back, yeah. Oh, God.
Well, they'll be ready to fight now, but do they even want to fight?
They have to fight now. She has to buy back. She's useless if she doesn't win a fight right now. But there's still a buyback penalty, so even if she gets kills, it's not a lot of gold. So they kind of have to wait that out before they go. But this is so bad. The rest of the team is smoked. They can bait with Quop, maybe. That's like, but they know. Bulgarian squad here knows. The only thing they can do now is look for a team fight, because otherwise Quop wasted 2k gold right there, and it's not going to be good at all for Quop. Oh, that was a big blunder. Now she was at least ahead of Magnus, was not too far behind Winner, like 4k gold behind. Now she's 7k behind, like not even a factor anymore as a core compared to what Bulgarian has. So That was a costly mistake. I think it's gonna really show in the next fight how weak this corp is gonna be.
Maybe a little bit of an impulse buyback that one. Like, I mean, you would expect the enemy team after grabbing the Aegis and Cheese to try to go for a high ground push. In which case, as Denmark, that's where you have probably your greatest strength. You know, next to fighting in the Roshan pit, if you can somehow get that. But yeah, just save your duration. Just try to get Bulgaria to overcommit and then surprise them with the buyback. For whatever reason, that buyback was used, and now it's really going to be hurting the Queen of Pain. She doesn't have her BKB just yet, and since the push is coming, I don't know if she's actually going to find enough farm to grab the BKB before these heroes actually arrive at the Radiant map. They're going to actually wrap around and see Ives right now. Hawkeye's right behind, and no, there's no freezing field here. They also get the curse onto the Magnus, destroy him. Sonic Wave will fly through, but it doesn't even matter. Magnus does have an RP and buyback. He will do just that. For Bulgaria, they have expended pretty much nothing. They have Flesh Column used, whatever. Oh, big hit on Tostominen, however. I think they may be a little bit scared to continue, but with Focus Fire, they really don't have to commit anyone but nowhere, and they have the maxed out Embrace at this point, so they force out two buybacks. They know if they kill off Magnus or Queen of Pain, it is not necessarily game, but it's definitely Raxes at that point, and they just have to keep their positioning.
Yeah, it's very hard for Magnus now to be looking for anything. He can easily get Windrunner, but just Aegis, so it's not really here you want to go on. And
Hawkeye.
He has to be careful. Hawkeye going very aggressive.
Found the Lich, Walrus Punch, Shard, Snowball. No Chain Frost for this fight. They're right next to the Ember Spirit. Sonic Wave again is up, but it's not nearly enough to kill off this Tusk. Another kill. They're just bleeding out right now. They will lose Pure Evil to the cleave of the Ember Spirit.
Oh, double gem down. They need to pick that up.
Unfortunately,
this is where Magnus should be looking.
Yule Scepter. Where's the blink RP? It's not there yet. The zombie's actually going to be spawned, and that means he can't blink in.
Yeah.
Couldn't force staff in there either, so great defensive play there from Stoneman. And they do get a gem, Denmark, on one of their heroes, I think. Where the hell did the gem go? I'm not really sure what happened, but one gem is still held on Team Bulgaria. The other gem is around on the Radiant Courier, actually, but
yeah,
Bulgaria, they walk in, take melee Raxes, walk out. They still have Aegis. They should still have Cheese, and they do. So, yeah, that's a successful push. Now do it again up towards top lane.
Yeah, buyback use on Magnus, so it's just a good fight for Bulgaria. They're just completely dominating this game, to be honest, right now. Ember is, I think, oh, he bought MKB. I guess you're forced to go MKB with Butterfly, but he needs a Divine, I think. There's no other item now. It's Divine or lose the game at this point. And I would be really surprised if he doesn't try and get the Divine. He picked up the Blink though, so he's a long way away from it. If this was just 2k gold, he would be pretty close to Divine by now.
Yeah, I mean, he had a Demon Edge involved there in the MKB, but unfortunately, he isn't going to go for that just yet. I mean, he's still doing a hell of a lot of damage, but he's like the only damage output. That's really the problem here for Denmark and for Bulgaria. They will have to deal with this split push kind of in mid lane, but they're kind of playing this a little bit slower than I would think. They kind of shoved top lane, but not fully. Are they actually looking for a pickoff now? Tusk still has that Shadow Blade, so they kind of want to be fighting outside of the enemy base, if at all possible. But no, they're just going to go for mid lane, it seems. It's a little bit more difficult than going for top, but with the Satanic Cheese and Aegis still up for quite a long time now. Denmark, again, all in on this Magnus, all in on some lucky crits, perhaps, for this Ember Spirit. The explosiveness, the versatility of these fights for Denmark is real. They have to find their angle, but do you really want to jump in RP the Windranger with Aegis, or the Gyrocopter, who has shown is just unkillable? It's like, there aren't really no good options here for Denmark for RPs unless you get to the back lines. Blink Skewer at this point might be a little bit more viable, but no, Blink Sonic Wave will kill off the Windranger. Oh. Just loses the Aegis! No Windranger for this fight, and now they get the RP only onto the Gyrocopter curse. Not
yes,
used just yet, but the Gyrocopter now hops into Panic. He'll be just fine. He's right on top of the Ember Spirit as well. That's 3 heroes down, however, for Team Bulgaria. It's a Gyrocopter Undying versus the world as the Magnus does leave. And Stoneman is going to get chained down by the Ember Spirit. TP out from the Magnus. They're going to chase forward looking for this Gyrocopter. This is where the Ember Spirit's Blink Dagger comes into play. Searing Chain, Sleight of Fist is up. It's going to lash him down in Gyrocopter. He's going to turn around and will really scare the bands off of them. They aren't really convinced they could go for this fight really easily, but the Gyrocopter needs something to flat cannon off of, I feel, so he can actually get these kills on the Ember Spirit, who's taking a couple of flat cannon shots, will fall. This Gyrocopter is just unstoppable. Missile's going to be fired towards the Queen of Pain. That won't land. But that was the worst timing in the world for the Windranger to lose that Aegis. I thought she had it for a little while longer.
Yeah, that was major props to Denmark. That was very nicely timed. They caught caught Windrunner with his, with her pants down, and unfortunate to lose Ember there. I think that was a kill that he necessarily didn't have to feed away, but they wanted to force the cheese from Gyra. I think that was their plan. Maybe even get the kill if he wasn't gonna use the cheese. And however, Gyro Cop turned it and got the kill on Ember, and that kind of salvaged the situation for Bulgarian on the other side now, because Ember, the thing I think they're scared about the most is the Divine on Ember right now that's gonna come out eventually. But that delayed, I think the next fight, Ember would have had Divine if he didn't go down there, because he would have like pretty much 4k gold right now, and he would have farmed that extra 2k to get the Divine. So a very costly kill, and he's dead for 100 seconds there. So it's gonna take him quite some time to respawn and be able to farm that amount of cola.
And also the Gyrocopter, because he did survive, and only know because he has 400 CS and 10-112 is his kill score, has almost 7,000 gold to spend. I'm not really sure if you even want to get travels just yet, since it doesn't seem like there's any need to teleport back. Going for an MKB, something like that, maybe a Daedalus, who knows for the Gyro, but either way, he's going to be doing a lot more damage, and he already is doing a disgusting amount of damage in these fights, at least compared to what Denmark are putting out and what the rest of the Bulgarian heroes are putting out. So Gyrocopter, at a certain point, is worth solo RPing. I'm not sure if he's at that point just yet. They would obviously like to get more heroes in the Gyrocopter, but now with an MKB completed and buyback in the bank if needed, and a double damage rune, yeah, they could go for another push with, even without the Cheese and Aegis.
Yeah, and Magnus went for Boots of Travel, which I'm a bit unsure about. Not really sure what the point of the Boots of Travel is at this point. He's not the one split pushing it away. So he could be 2k gold closer to Refresher, I feel like he's gonna be looking right now. Tosca's Invis and DD though.
Shard Snowball, dropping Fury down half HP. However, the Skewer is gonna bring the Tusk very far away from his buddies.
He has to blink away.
Yeah, he has a blink. He's going to get it out and actually drag the Scream with him. Ives is in the corner. Got some hero range creeps here, but now Hawkeye chained to the deck is going to pop the sigil and some shards slowed down, though, taking so much damage. We'll turn around for a Walrus Punch. Actually, that's quite a bit of damage, but his allies have completely abandoned him. And who knows, maybe blink down to the low ground, a little bit of better decision. I don't know, but yeah, this is going to be the Tusk to fall, and that is going to put a stop to any sort of aggressive potential from Bulgaria. Surprised that they went with that with just the Tusk. Like, no one else really wanted to fight that.
I think that was miscommunication. I think the Tusk goal was okay. There was like, you're on your own, dude. If you die, you die. We don't really care. We don't want to fight right now for some reason. And I think it's fine. I think Quop again going down on bottom lane. Winan just destroying Quop. I actually think Winan is one of the counters to Quop in mid to late game. This is what happens. Quop can't get an item to deal with this. Linkage is like the only option, but even that is pretty mediocre.
Well, Lincoln's in this game actually was saved from the Green of Vane and from the Curse of the Winter Wyvern. You definitely do a lot worse with this particular draft, but yeah, I agree. Like, as a Queen of Pain, you really want to be kind of mixed up in those big fights with the BKB up and landing those big Sonic Waves. In small-scale engagements, even if you do have an Orchid, even if you have a Sheepstick, it's so hard to land that before Nowhere actually lands the Shackle. If you do somehow, like, Orchid or Sheep when the Shackle Bola is in mid-flight, you can prevent the Focus Fire, maybe. These are just such narrow timings, and Nowhere, even with just like a Daedalus, is doing so much freaking damage. Like, she doesn't really have the farm comparable to the Gyrocopter, but still, she's doing single target damage that's, you know, surpassing the Gyrocopter easily. Plus, you know, has 6,400 gold in the bank herself. She will probably need to get travel or something like that, because she's kind of running out of space. She doesn't really want to get rid of any of these items. Or, you know, screw that, drop the TP scroll, get Aegis or Cheese. That seems like a little bit better.
Yeah, I'm not sure what I don't really like holding this much gold and not buying anything with it. It's and pushing high ground or anything like mm-hmm. that. It's I feel like she could, I guess the plan could be use Aegis, die again, buy Boots of Travel, and buy back TP in. So that's how you use your gold. Maybe you can ensure the game by winning that. That's a fine way to play this out. If that's not it, I really dislike holding this much gold. It's pretty bad to have 7k gold on a hero that's just not being used, pretty much.
Yeah, just like purely theory crafting, it shows you how much surplus gold you have. above your buyback threshold, and that should in theory always be at zero for the most part. Like, you want to be using all the gold that you have so that you can actually, you know, be useful with the gold that you're getting. But holding 5,000 in gold, is that's just excessive. I can understand like buying one-shot items, like surprise items like BKB or Satanic, those huge swingy items in the fights, but yeah, this is a little bit too much gold. Oh, here we go. The doctor is in. And the only problem here for the Ember Spirit is that he has absolutely no HP. He will have the Lich's armor, which is, I guess, kind of nice. He has strength treads, but if he does get hit with a Shackle, Focus Fire, or even like a full Gyrocopter, Flat Cannon Barrage, he can just get annihilated. And the Divine Rapier in the hands of the Gyrocopter or Windranger is big game, but here we go. This is the all-in counter push play here from Denmark. They're going to smoke up, look for a wraparound. Unfortunately for them, they're not going... Oh, wait, no, they actually at a really good angle right now. Ives is going to charge forward. Nowhere is not going to get hit with the skewer. Pops the BKB. Fails Shackle and Fury. However, the Sonic Wave cuts through and the Ember Spirit doing so much damage. Drop Hawkeye super low, but Fury's going to die first. Chain Frost is going to be thrown, but everyone's BKB'd. They're going to charge forward looking for Korean Zombie. This Lich is not going to be escaping anytime soon. We get worked down. This Gyrocopter does so much damage, but no one else is able to actually contribute and kill off that Tusk. They do have a buyback on the Magnus, and they will be forced to expend it right now. He still has that RP available. He'll have to land a good one, because still Blink RP into Sleight of Fist, that can just insta-kill a couple of these Bulgarian heroes, but they gotta go soon. And by soon, I mean right about now.
Oh, the splits.
Oh, this is gonna be so tense. Look at the damage. It's almost gonna straight kill off nowhere, but he's still alive and still has the Aegis. He's gonna get healed up a little bit by the Embrace, jump forward for KSPR, not gonna throw the Sonic Wave. Nowhere, still surviving, gets Glimmered out again. How the hell is Windranger living? I have no idea, but she kills off the mid Raxes.
10k gold on her, yeah.
Oh my god. Like, this is just dirty amounts of gold. Start a trust fund or something. Pure Evil now is going to have so much time to heal everyone back up so they can go for the last set of Raxes.
Yeah, and Magnus just panicking. Full on, like, I'm going to skewer no one and just die. And then Ember is like, but my damage, I can't do anything without you. And he just forced the buyback into those racks. That was their big chance, and Magnus, oh, that was some nice play though. But it wasn't him.
The classic four staff in the tombstone play. He'll dodge
Hawkeye? Or you? I guess he's just play spreading.
Yeah. Hawkeye's going deep right now. The Undying's gonna help him, but Hawkeye will immediately fall stone in. His tombstone isn't going to last for super long. They get the curse onto Fury just to hold him out so that the Windranger and Gyrocopter can kill off the buildings. And they're doing just that. Blink into the backlines. Ibs is going to try to take down Nowhere. But again, this Windranger, she has her Aegis. They get the RP onto the Gyrocopter right now. No Satanic available. They'll drop him. Nowhere focusing fire onto the Mega Creeps. She'll get him. And may die twice, but everyone and their mom has buybacks for Bulgaria. Actually, no, Tusk doesn't. Blink out from the Windranger. Gotta run fast, but Yule Scepter's gonna catch her. Into a Shockwave. She's gonna turn around and fight, doing so much damage to the Queen of Pain, but not quite enough. Here comes the Ember. We'll squash her. But now I think it's desperation, final push mode time for Denmark. Like, even though Ember Spirit's great at clearing off Megas, especially with the Divine Rapier, they're just not in any position they could sit back and let Bulgaria push again.
It's time to go mid. You have no other choice. You have to go right now. You have to force buybacks, and I'm not even sure if you can. Because the only hero who can clean waves is Ember, and he has to be in base defending against Megas. So they have to... I don't know. It's going to be so hard. I don't think even Bulgaria has to use any buybacks here. And are they... They can't just stand in base. There's no way. They have to go right now. I'm be very surprised if they don't go. But they won't get anything. They can't force anything until the Bulgarian squad has... is up. Like, they might be able to get Rax mid before Winner spawns, but that doesn't matter. Bulgaria knows that the mid Rax doesn't matter. It's only if their throne survives, they can re-go later and just use all their buybacks to end the game pretty much. Winner gonna pick up Hex, one nice pickup at least there, but this is gonna be do or die for Denmark for sure.
I don't think they're really doing fast enough. The Ember Spirit is the one who clears these creeps the fastest. Like, one Sleight of Fist clears out an entire wave of Megas. But again, this is the problem where he doesn't have any survivability, has no lifesteal or anything like that, so he's just going to get worked down by the Megas. They're finally going to take down the Tier 2, but only have a 20-second window to take down the Tier 3. And at this point for Bulgaria, they can even concede the Raxes, and that won't matter. They, I think,
they
have...
can't go.
Yeah, it's over.
Ember used Boots of Travel to... TP home to push out after pushing a lane, so I don't know. I feel like Denmark are this is not a situation they're comfortable with at all, which is not too surprising. But they don't know what to do anymore. Like they really don't know. They have to rely on Bulgaria making a mistake at this point to win.
Chain Frost from Lich will clear out a wave. You can do that again in a minute, I suppose, but a Gobble Gary, they're gonna smoke up. Know that someone's here. Nora's gonna blink straight into Ives. And CM has been doing so well this entire game, but unfortunately this time just not gonna happen. Blink forward for the Yule Scepter. They have a curse if needed, but they definitely won't need it. Green Zombie will actually get up to the high ground with the Force Staff. So he may get away, but no, Nowhere is right on his tail. Oops. Has a Sheepstick. Run, Korean Zombie, run. He's gonna trap in the shards and he'll get squashed as well. Okay, well, now it's a 3v5. Five-man RP, five-man Divine Rapier crits.
I don't know how many Divines he needs now to defend. So more than one for sure.
He spent too much money on travels, though. Level 2 travels could have been, like, some of Divine Rapier. But as long as...
Find out for Shackle now.
Nowhere looking for it. Or just Blink Curse. That's good, too. Ember Spirit not even getting shackled properly, and it doesn't even matter. They'll throw a Sonic Wave out. They'll do what they can. The Divine Rapier is on the deck, and they're not even bothering with it. No, Nowhere's going to grab it for the road. That's good game, well played.
Yeah, there was no way for Denmark at the end. If they had taken tier 2 towers earlier, maybe they could have went for all in, but they had to trade towers, and they had no Herics at them that could even start pushing. It took them so long to push four people in mid. It took them like 5-10 seconds per wave, and it wasn't enough. They just lost way earlier. They lost... When they lost Megas, I think it was pretty much game over.
Alright guys, that's going to be it for right now. We have another game actually coming up in 30 minutes. That one is going to be between... Oh man, who's going to be between? I want to say Bosnia and someone else, I think. I have to check. I'll pull that up right away. But this is going to put Bulgaria on top of the group right now. They're done playing their games. They have a total of 5 points with 1 win now and 2 draws. Russia has only played one game. Denmark might be out of it actually at this point, but Kazakhstan still has one more to play, and if they just draw, then they'll be tied, so we have an awkward situation going on there. But for right now, we're going to cut it to a short break. I'm Mike Loris. Hope you enjoyed the cast. If you did, be sure to stick around for the next game. There is also, again, Bosnia versus Turkey coming up in 30 minutes. I've been joined by Kefka. Be sure to follow us both at Mike Loris and at Kefka Dota. It's both on the screen, and we'll be right back for the next match, guys. Don't go anywhere.